and increase in cardio, respiratory, and muscular fitness. Same thing is physical activities. Things that I just mentioned. It. Take the train. Take the bus sometimes. Do something different. Walk. Get up in the morning. If you're not going to work, take a walk outside. It's not bad. There's nothing wrong with this thing. We just don't want to do it because we're doing, I'm too big for it. Why should I do it? But hey, let me tell you something. Let me tell you what I...
When you call me.
Yes. Let me tell you what I told my dad. Daddy, I love you. Yes, very much. But you know what? I can't help you when you're sick. I can't do anything for you. When you get to the hospital, you're by yourself. You're the one that will get the injection. Not me, not Zainab, but you. It's only going to be Mr. David Ibrahim, not Zainab Ibrahim. That's it. I will just come and tell you, Daddy, that's all I can do. And that's all anybody who's related to you can do for you. Except you decide to do it yourself. Alcohol, sweetened beverage, soda. We drink soda here.
You don't drink alcohol.
Soda drinkers.
Diet,
it doesn't help. It's the same. That's the next one. It's the same. Same thing. I have a picture. There's a picture that I have to show. Okay. Sugar overload. Okay, so this is Coke. This is a... the regular Coke, kidding? It has 16 teaspoons of sugar in it. You know the regular teaspoon. So I'm going to sit down and give you a teaspoon and I'm going to ask you to eat 16 teaspoons of sugar. But that's what we're taking here now.
I tell you, I miss it, but don't
call. It doesn't make any difference. It's the same content. Because let me do this. Portion, let me do. Okay, so here, let's assume this is 16 ounces. Mm-hmm. And this is 2 servings. I think I have a over there. This is 2 servings. You're supposed to share this with somebody. And each serving of this is like 250 calories. Are you going to drink everything? Well, if you decide to drink everything, how much calories have you taken? 500. Because you've taken for 2 people.
Okay.
Yes. So that's how it works. So even if you take, let's say this is 16 ounces, you take 8 ounces, you put it in a cup, then you put 24 ounces of water.
No, 248.
Does it reduce the fact that it's 25? Yeah, the taste will go away, but it doesn't actually take out the sugar. It doesn't take away the sugar. It's still the same. What takes away the sugar is you not drinking the whole 16 ounces. You drink 4. For a grown-up, if you're going to drink juice, no more than 6 ounces in a day. We don't need it. What do you need juice for anyway? What is it for, if not excess sugar? Hell, not here. Okay. Yes.
Suppose instead of all these, you start taking water. That's
you can never get it wrong if you drink water.
But I just like to know what,
zero calories.
Measurements you put over there to differentiate cold, Sprite or whatever. But what I'm saying is that is there any advantage in drinking water over all these?
Yes, because water is zero calories. There's no sugar, teaspoon sugar in there. There's no anything. Water takes care of your temperature. Water takes care of a lot of things. Water takes care of your muscles in your body and all of that. Meanwhile, this thing.
We should not go on here.
This thing takes care of your diabetes for you. Your blood sugar does go up.
What about
look at water here. I think this is water, zero calories.
What about orange juice?
It's the same thing. Drink in moderation. Okay, so I need us to listen to this part, emotional wellness. This is very, very important that we do. when somebody comes to you and tell you that, I'm really stressed, I don't even know what to do. How do we take care of it as Nigerians?
Sleep.
What's the easiest thing that we do when somebody comes to you and they tell you something is wrong with you?
I'll need that table soon, come rest.
But we don't do that though. That's not what we do. Think of Fato Shejo, Lenin, Yobrinian, Yaku Mashabane. That's what we do.
No. And don't I feel like I don't go there.
Anybody, I have noticed, I have seen it a lot of times. We know it. Sarcasm. That's what we do. We push it aside. Yes, we push it aside. But really, the person here, the person, what the person is going on, that the person is going through here, you can't quantify it. And when you tell somebody that is highly stressed, the person will just pull back and would not say anything again. Goes back home. Guess what starts? Depression. You will see them, they will smile at you, they will be amongst you, but when they go home at night, it's horrible. It's very horrible. So we need to pay more attention. It is also important to have a healthy social life by keeping good and positive friends. This, listen, my principle that I stick to, I've stuck to it for like 6 years now and it's not changing. If you are a negative person, you have no business being around me. If I can sense it like 1 inch close like this or even less than, that you're a negative person, there's nothing that I'm looking for around you. You know why? Because I am positive, you are negative. It's very easy to attract negative than to take positive. Positive, we are always in denial. You're going to be in denial for a very long time before you finally realize that, okay, this is positive, let me stick to it. But negative, that's very easy to do. But you're not going to quickly find that person. How did you reply to the person? How did you take yourself away from the situation? We don't do that. It's part of helping you. When you find yourself among negative, if you find 100 negativity like this, look for just one positive. One, it's okay. That's all you need. One is okay. You find it, you take it, you move on.
I find out that a lot of people use that word stress easy.
Yes.
Without being under stress, maybe they tried something, it's not coming their way. Oh, I'm stressed.
Yes.
It's not because they're
stressed. They give up too easily.
So, but then if you encounter someone that's really under stress, how do you manage that before you start doing the classes?
Okay, so say supposing you find somebody that is highly stressed. As a human being, I have come to realize that you don't really need to say anything. You just need to sit down and listen. Let the person talk. You cannot be judgmental. You just have to listen first. When somebody tells you, this is wrong with me, they want to vent. That's the first thing that we all do. You just want to come out with the thing in your mind. Let the person do it. When the person does it, then you can start asking questions. And don't ask a yes or no answer. Don't ask questions that will give you yes or no. Ask questions that will make the person talk. The person needs to trust you enough before they can talk to you. If I tell you something, and the next day that I go there, to Sapuya Bashira, I'm not coming back to you again. No, I'm not coming back to you. So those things, it takes a lot to learn all those things. But I have really found out that when somebody comes to talk to you, just be patient, just listen to the person. Don't judge. Because, hey, it can happen to you too. And then with time, it takes time to heal or to go through all of these things before the person now realizes that. You just have to ask for some, to make the person realize that what they're going through, somebody else is going through worse. But it takes a lot of time. Did that answer your question? Yeah. Okay. All right. The heart needs laughter. The heart needs laughter, and the brain does too, to remain active and alert. Take stress management and other classes if you have to. There's nothing wrong in that. If you're highly stressed, go on YouTube. There's everything on YouTube these days. Type in anger management classes. Type in stress management classes. Sit down and listen to it. If you have to listen to your Quran recitation on the radio, listen to it. But make sure that when you're listening to all those things, you're actually connecting with those messages, not just hearing it and it's coming here. You have to connect with it, because those are the things that reduces your emotional stress that you have. Exercise does help keep stress down. Rest your brain from excessive work. Load, take breaks, vacation as much as you can. I made a land of vacation, be back. If you go to Nigeria, Nigeria is not vacation, sorry. It's not vacation. No.
Just home.
How many of us work 40 hours a week here? Your business or somebody else's job? We all do, most of us do. How many of us pay bills here? Everybody. And by the time you end the bill, how much is left for you in your account? How many of us will sit down and organize parties here? And buy Ashwebi and use money, $700 to buy Ashwebi. But what if you take that $700? You go to Poconos. You just relax. Just relax. That's all you need. You need a break before you just slam. God forbid. Just go. It doesn't take anything. But that's what we say. God forbid. We say that. God forbid is what we say. But you need to relax. Take it easy. It's not the end of the world. When you don't have, sometimes I don't even have $1. And nobody knows. Nobody knows. You have to take things easy. Go on vacation. There's nothing un-African about not going to vacation. You know, like a Mac Pine, our Africans are on love vacation. You don't even boy. You're working so hard.
Employee of the month.
Yeah. I never
We need to take it easy. Go out to dinner. Get your family. Do something with family. Go out. Sit down. Applebee's everywhere. Sit down. Have a good conversation. Healthy conversation. Trust me, little things like this makes a difference. We ignore it because we think we're Africans, we don't need to do that. But we should learn. We all live in a country where all these things are available. When you live in Rome, you learn to be like Romans. You do so. All work and no play makes the guys Ibrahim the dull woman. As the saying goes.
Why are you Ibrahim?
Because I'm here, Brian. Yes.
There's a question.
Yes. All right, so I don't think there's anything wrong. There's nothing wrong when you have a one night out with your wife, husband. It is not wrong.
Better you relax.
It's love.
Rest, not rest.
It's love.
I'm a headache, 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 I'm a head
part of rest.
Only King Nasacha would be back on test in the neck. Other Ratimons are taking in here, not so clean.
Yeah, we know there's health disparity.
Okay, so I'm going to use myself as an example. I don't do organic food. You know why? Because I think it's an absolute waste of money. It's absolute waste of money. What they sell as organic is what we grow in Nigeria. That's what we grow naturally in Nigeria. And that's why it's so expensive, because they don't have that natural resources here to grow all this. Now, the thing is, how much can you buy? How much of this organic can you buy that will serve your family for a week? Well, you really must be making maybe $300,000 a year for you to come here and do that, especially if you're a family of 4, 3, 2, or 6.
How I like building.
If you're a family of 2 and you can afford more power to eat, but it doesn't really make any difference, because if you're eating the same organic food, you're eating it in large portions, you're going to end up with the same thing that you do. The regular. But I always tell people, if you want to go to the supermarket, get coupons. Get coupons. Go to farmers market. Look for when things are on sale. I do it too. There's nothing wrong with that. It does not make you lower than anybody or better than anybody. Or anybody better than anything. I look for coupons. Yeah, where are you? She looks for coupons for me. We ask, where Bonot in Thailand, Bonot in Thailand. I'm not very about that. I see how much Batimes is in sales. So why can't we do the same thing for food? If you have a backyard in your house that you can grow things, fine. You can do that. Have you time. Keep still and meditate. We don't do these things. You time means your own time. Your own time. Maybe 20 minutes. 20 minutes. When you wake up in the morning, keep still for 20 minutes. Keep still. Don't pick up your phone. Don't talk to anybody. Don't do anything. Just keep still and think about yourself. Think about things that you did yesterday and today you're gonna do tomorrow. Practice it. It helps. It does help. It gives you energy. It gives you vision. You get to know that, okay, today this is what I'm going to go do. Nigerians don't take the above seriously. We don't take it seriously. Nigeria, make him over a vacation. Nigeria, I'm going to go. Michelle, I love you. Nigeria, I'm going to go. Hello, Michelle, I'm going to go. What's your father? I'm still going to go. Excessive eating or inadequate eating can be due to stress and depression. Stress eating is very common. You're stressed and you eat a lot. You see people that tells you they like chocolate cake, or they like chocolate, or they like cake, or they like ice cream a lot. Or they sit down and just sit down in front of the TV and just dip the spoon and just eat the ice cream. That's stress eating. It's very easy to stress eat. You stress, there's nobody to talk to. The few people that you want to talk to, they don't care. They don't seem to care. The only thing that you find confident, you find joy in, is just to sit down and stuff your face. Stuff your face and you gain weight. Or you get all these things. Stress is part of life. It's not going anywhere. Learn to manage your stress level as much as you can. Stress will always be there. It's not going anywhere. See a doctor if you have to. You're not alone in the world of stress. I get stressed too. Emotional wellness. So I put this picture there. Have a positive attitude, high self-esteem, a strong sense of self, and the ability to recognize and share a wide range of feelings with others in a constructive way. Most of us cannot tell our problems to the people that we claim that we love. We hide it, we suppress it. You suppress your pain. You suppress your hurt. Somebody hurts you. You can't tell it to anybody. You just ignore it. The easiest thing I would say, ignore it, darling. Ignore it, darling.
That's how we brought up.
No, it's not good. A lot of awareness. We're creating a lot of. I have a Facebook page, but I create all this awareness. We need to recognize. You need to recognize it when you're hurt. When you're in pain, you need to recognize it. Hello.
Hey.
Please. When you are hurt, you need to recognize it. If you don't recognize it, you will look for one food or something to do. You will drink soda, you will eat eba, you will eat yam, you will eat all these things. It's so easy to fall to food. But recognize your pain and go through your pain so you can heal. Don't push it aside. The more you push it aside, the more it fills up like this. And you know what happens when it fills up? You blow up. That's what happens. We're all humans, man or woman. You have one brain, I have one head, two eyes, two ears, everything. We have a heart, we have kidneys, we have the same thing. If you don't go through your pain so you can heal, you will end up highly stressed and fall to food. And then it leads to all this craziness that we're talking about. I think I'm almost done. That's it. Physical wellness. Oh, men that don't go to the doctors. How many of you guys went to the doctor? When was the last time you did a physical?
Coca-Cola-tale.
Coca-Cola-tale.
Okay, who has medical insurance here?
Me. Ali.
How much do you pay for?
Wow, for free.
For free?
All that
you want. Okay, all right. Well, how much does the Yahoo pay for it, though?
Yahoo? Yeah, when she said for me, she said
me.
Okay, let's use it. Use it. Use your medical insurance. 1 year. One time a year.
Go for your not wasting.
Please go. It's very important. It's very important. The reason why this thing is so close to my heart. My dad is very sick. My dad is very sick. And it's because he ignored all these things that I'm talking about. He ignored it. You know what he tells me? I'm a man. It can never happen to me. That's what we do.
Your dad is old already.
My dad is 74. No, this kind of one. He has all these things that I'm talking about. He has all these things. Let's don't justify things that we're not supposed to justify. Take care of yourself. Please, do it. It doesn't cost anything. Do it. Do it. See? Don't care what anybody else tells you. Take care of your health. I'm okay. But there are some things that we cause by ourselves that we can prevent. Cooking tips, reduce salt, reduce your salt, use onions, use garlic, use herbs before you put salt in food. No salt. You don't need it, but you have to have a so gent, 30 feet, what's that? 30 feet garlic, you see. Go to eat your one. Taste it before you end up putting salt in it. Don't put too much salt. Okay. This is food label. When you have two servings. Okay, so this is 8 servings per container. For every serving, it has 230 calories. It has 230 calories in it. By the time you eat all this 8 servings, you times this by 8. You end up with that much calories. So that's how you pack up all these calories. Because we don't eat little, small.
Huh?
Metabolism.
Africans, take home reality. High risk of diabetes and hypertension. Family history, check it. Know your family history. We are humans, made of flesh and blood. If you don't take care of your body and what you feed it, it should break down. There is no magic to it. We all have one medicine problem or the other. I mentioned that. Food is affordable here. There's absolutely no time you will go to the supermarket that you won't find what you have. Stop being ashamed of your medical problem. You are not alone. Learn to live with it. Live with your medical problem. Live with it. Be happy with it. You will probably get very well when you keep an open mind and live outside the box.
You're right.
I think that's the end.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
The only thing is timid.
Oh,
no, it's not a question. Everything.